Hi, and welcome to another edition of Crossword, coming from Crossworks Ministries. So today the scripture is coming from Romans chapter 4, verse 20. And Paul is actually talking about Abraham in the scripture, and it says, "He did not waver at the promise of God through unbelief, but he was strengthened in faith, giving glory to God." So what I want to talk to you about today is the promises of God are yes and amen. There are hundreds of promises in the scripture. And I know you can probably relate to when a promise is delayed, unbelief will start to try and creep in on you. You'll start to wonder if my behavior has changed God's mind, or the promise is not going to happen. And you start to slip out of faith. But I want you to be encouraged today and know that God's promises are not based on behavior. They might delay it, but they're all yes and amen. Abraham had to just stay in faith, so much so that God changed his name to, it was Abram when he got the promise. God changed his name to Abraham so that he would consistently every day hear, "You're the father of many nations, father of many nations. Your wife might be barren. You don't have any children, but you're the father of many nations. You're the father of many nations." He kept hearing that over and over again when God changed his name to Abraham. And not long after that, the promise came to pass. So I want you to be encouraged today and know that you begin to speak those promises over your life and cut off unbelief. That's how it says at the end of the scripture, giving glory to God. How do you give glory to God? By speaking his promises and causing those promises to fall into your heart like seed. And when you do that, your faith is going to grow and you're going to see that promise manifested in your life. So we just want to continue to believe God together for every promise, healing, provision, protection, whatever it is, maybe something specific you're believing God for. Don't let unbelief creep in. Give glory to God by speaking his promise out loud. Let's pray. Father, we thank you today that you've given us the way to build our faith by giving you glory and speaking your word and knowing that your promises to us are yes and amen, that you are going to fulfill it in our lives. I thank you, Lord, for blessing my brother and sister and keeping them built up and not allowing unbelief to creep in on them. We praise you and we thank you for it in Jesus' name. Amen. I hope you have a great week and remember the promises of God. Keep them in your mouth and you'll soon have it in your hand. The cross works.